Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology again. And finally, we are on the verge of eclipse. So, today night, there is the eclipse in the sign of Sagittarius. Today night or tomorrow, depending on where you stay and when you are seeing this video. And we will discuss on some remedies and some procedures which we can do during this eclipse. Apart from fasting and similar things which people do in the Vedic context. All right. So, as usual, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding this eclipse and how it will affect you in confluence with your dashas in your birth chart, then you can always go to my website to book a reading with me. You will find it down in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you shall find Him. Alright, so I have made two videos on this eclipse, so I will not speak much about the eclipse here. So if you have not watched the two videos, then you can type eclipse in my channel, you will find them. You can type in YouTube, Eclipse Exotic Astrology. So there you will see two, three videos. The first, you can see that. Alright, so this eclipse is happening in the sign of Sagittarius. So therefore, I will speak about some general remedies for eclipses and specifically for this eclipse, what we should be doing. So, what are some of the general remedies that we can do? Now, these remedies have to be done depending on what your situation is. So, for example, if you are not able to do a particular remedy, then there are various levels and various gradations to which you can try to do. So the first remedy which we can do is to fast. Okay, so if you fast, then what happens is what is eclipse basically? Eclipse is the onslaught of karma which comes. Okay, so fasting makes our body more receptive to change. You will always see that if you fast for around 36 hours, which means if you eat today night, and then if you don't eat anything the next day, and then the day after tomorrow, if you eat in the morning, then you will see that your brain has a lot of clarity. You are very clear about what to do, and you know, there's no laziness inside of you, because you have done some level of tapasya, some level of austerity, and that austerity has empowered you to be very clear in life. So therefore, you can do a 36-hour fast. And when I say fast, I mean to say without water, without any food, dry fruits, fruits, any grains, anything else. Now, suppose you cannot do that, then for 36 hours, you should do the fast with water, which means you only take water and that's all, nothing else. Now, if you can't do that, then along with water, you can take some juice, okay, fruit juice, not those Tropicana or Real or all these things which we find in the market, you know, fresh fruit juice, okay. And if you can't do that also, then you can do fresh fruit juice with dry fruits. You can have dry fruits or fruits, okay. And if you can't do that also, if that also is not possible for you, you need more, then you can do with Ekadashi items, which means you do not take grains. So at least this we can do during the eclipse. We must avoid grains during this time. And therefore, we can use things like Rajgir Atta, or we can use Sabudana. You can make a lot of dishes using Rajgir Atta, you can make Sabudana Khichdi, you can make Sabudana Kheer, these kind of things you can make. Although eclipse is not a very good time to indulge in sweet products, so just eat to whatever extent it is required. And try to abstain yourself from doing any kind of, regarding eating any kind of sweet dishes, okay. So even if you're eating milk or drinking milk, do it without sugar, without jaggery, without any flavor. Just keep it very simple. And this is the last thing that you should be going down to. I mean, we cannot take grains these days, okay? At least for 36 hours, it's not recommended. But yeah, if you have some medical condition and The doctor has suggested you to take grains, carbohydrates every day specifically. Then you can do, don't do this and then faint and go to the hospital and don't say that this guy told me in the video, so he's responsible for my disease. All right, so I'm not responsible. And you can consult your doctor. If your doctor allows, then you can go ahead with this. That is very important for fasting. Then the next thing we should do is we should try to get up early in the morning during the eclipse, and ideally we should take a day off, right? So we should take holiday during that day, and after that we should try to take a bath early in the morning in cold water, preferably. Again, if you have medical conditions, you don't have to take, you can take bath in lukewarm water. And please wear fresh clothes that day. Fresh clothes means the cloth that you did not wear it before, okay, yesterday or day before, any day. Fresh doesn't mean new necessarily. Fresh means it's just washed and it's ready. Okay, so please wear fresh clothes during eclipse. It is very important. And apart from that, in the morning you should do strict sadhana every day, every eclipse. It's very much recommended, because during eclipse some certain things can happen during the day, depending on our horoscope of course, which can give us a lot of shock. Okay, but shock, it doesn't mean that you will die, or you know, you will get a heart attack, or you will have a divorce, or you'll be fired from job. But in some very rare cases I've seen, people get a lot of shocks, you know, like sometimes they discover that their partner is cheating on them, or you know, the son is, you know, into drinking alcohol or something like that, you know, the girl is also having bad habits. So children discover weird things about their parents, and sometimes parents also discover weird things about their children, as I said. So therefore it is important that we stabilize our consciousness in the morning so that we are ready for whatever comes. Okay, now if nothing happens, if it is just like another day, then it's perfectly fine. But in worst case, if something goes wrong, then let's be prepared for it. Okay, so what are the things that we should do in the morning? So when we get up in the morning, the first thing we should do on the day of eclipse, in fact ideally we should do this every day, we should offer prayers to our preceptors, to our gurus, to our mentors who have helped us evolve in the line of spirituality. And therefore we should chant this mantra: Om Agyan Timirandhasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. All right, this mantra is very important. This is a very famous mantra which is chanted. All right, so first we should offer prayers to our gurus. The problem is we directly go to God. We go to Lakshmi and Narayan. It doesn't work like that. Anything which is spiritual has to go through the guru. Otherwise God doesn't accept. Okay, because we are not that pure that we can make pure offerings. But when we offer our respects to the guru, then the guru offers our prayer to God. And because the guru is very dear to God, that is why God accepts whatever the guru offers to him on our behalf, right? So please follow the proper structure, the proper order. The parampara has to be followed. Otherwise, if you just go on doing things whimsically and think that you're very great, you know, you can directly connect with God, you can, you know, talk to God, you know, God is like your friend, you know, he's like your son, he's like your husband or wife. It doesn't work like that. It works maybe for Kunti, it works like that. For Draupadi, it works. You know, for Mirabai, it works. It works for Yudhishthir Maharaj. For Arjuna, Krishna is a friend. But we are not at that level. You know, we are nowhere near to even 0.00% of what they were. So let us not pretend to be a very self-realized, elevated yogis and then, you know, do things like, oh, mera Krishna hai, main isko khila dungi, you know, these kind of things. Well, you can do that. There's no problem. Intimacy is fine, but intimacy should be backed up with proper scriptural foundation and respect towards the guru. If that is not there, all our offerings are useless. We are just simply pretending to ourselves that we are very elevated, that we can, you know, directly talk to God or something like that. God came and spoke to us, you know, these kind of illusions people have many times. So understand that offering proper respects to the Guru is very crucial for our spiritual advancement. And once we do that, we can, many times people write poems for their gurus, and then people, they go and speak it out in front of their gurus. That also you can do, it's very good. Or you can just chant this mantra, and any other guru mantra that you know, you can chant. Okay, that is the basis. If the guru is there, then you are alive in spiritual life. If the guru is not there, I don't care who you are. You are not existing. You are simply an illusion, right? So pay respects to the gurus first, and only then do other things. So after that, what you should be doing is you should chant the Vishnu Sahasranam. Okay, you can type in YouTube Vishnu Sahasranam, and that you can chant, or you can at least hear. Okay, it will take you around 30-35 minutes if you hear it once. And when you are hearing, just try to pronounce it also. Try to speak it, try to sing that, and make sure you have the proper mindset, because this, the word Vishnu Sahasranama, Vishnu means Vishwa Anu. Vishwa means the entire universe. Anu means one who resides everywhere. So Vishnu, the word Vishnu means one who resides everywhere, in every dot, every atom, every, you know, proton, neutron. Every particle, he's there. He's the one who is sustaining everything. So Sahasra means thousand. Nama means name. So this Vishnu Sahasranam is a thousand names for Lord Vishnu, and thousand names to address Lord Vishnu. Okay. So therefore, this Vishnu Sahasranam is very important, because Lord Vishnu was the one who had chopped off the head of this demon, and that his head became Rahu, and then his body became Ketu. So if Vishnu is protecting us, so when we chant the Vishnu Sahasranam, the Sudarshan Chakra is always protecting us. All right. So when the Sudarshan Chakra is protecting us, then nothing of this world can touch us. Either it is Rahu or Ketu or Saturn or any other planet. What to speak of Rahu? Even Mercury, Venus cannot touch you. No. So therefore, Vishnu Sahasranam is very important. And another thing you can do is, next you can recite the Purusha Sukta prayers. All right. It starts like this: Om Sahasra Shesha Purusha. It's a very beautiful prayer. All right. So that is something which you can do. You can type in Google Purusha Sukta prayers. Okay. And that is generally done by Brahmins. But even if you are not a Brahmin, you can do it that day. It's not a problem. Okay. And many times people want to do Gayatri Mantra during eclipse. Gayatri Mantra is not recommended if you are not having initiation, right? And when I say initiation, I don't mean the first initiation, Harinam. I mean to say Brahman Diksha. If Brahmin Diksha is not there, if you don't have the thread, irrespective of your caste and birth, okay? So in the authorized sampradayas, even if you are not born in a Brahmin family, but if you follow certain spiritual principles and scriptural standards, then they can give you this Brahman thread. Okay, second initiation, that's initiation number two, not the first initiation. So if you have the Brahman initiation from your guru, and if your life is very pure, without eating meat or drinking wine or indulging with the opposite sex or gambling, if you are following these four principles, and you are chanting a particular number of rounds, and you are allowed to do worship of the deity, Archa, Vigraha, Pujan, only then you should be doing Gayatri. Otherwise, Gayatri is not recommended. Don't do Gayatri Mantra without that, okay? So, the Gayatri confusion is clear. So, Purusha Sukta prayers you can do. Apart from that, the next thing you can do is you can chant the Brahma Samhita. Brahma Samhita. What is Brahma Samhita? Brahma Samhita means, Samhita is like a collection of poems or verses or book. Okay. Now, Brahma means Lord Brahma has written. The four-headed creator, Lord Brahma, he has written. About whom? Not about himself. Not about any other person, you or me. He has written about Lord Vishnu and the spiritual world. All right. So, that he says, you know, Chintamani Prakhara Sadma Sukalpa Vriksha Laksha Vriteshu Surabhira Vipalayantam Govindamadi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami Angani Yasya Sakalendri Avritti Manti. So you can keep go, you can keep singing like this, you know, the entire Brahma Samhita that you can sing. So after the Purusha Sukta prayers, you can do that. The Brahma Samhita is extremely powerful. So you can type in YouTube, you will find videos, you know, Brahma Samhita videos. You will find it. They're amazing. Just go and read it, hear it with the meaning. The Brahma Samhita gives a description of the spiritual world. Lakshmi Sahasra Sata Sambrama Sevya Manam Govindam Adi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. So that is something which is very crucial to recite the Brahma Samhita, and ideally you should recite the Brahma Samhita at least once, or if time permits, three times. Okay, and after that you should recite very crucial Narayan mantras, which is very important, at least 8 rounds. 8 rounds means not 8 times, 108 times is one round. Okay. So, I'll just show you. This is the mala. Of course, Indians will be very aware of this, but sometimes Westerners are not. So, this is the mala, you see. Okay, I had done I had done a video and a workshop, you know, 21 days. So, this is the main beat, you know. This is known as the Guru beat. This is a bit different from the other beats, do you see? And then this is called the choti. Choti means there's a piece of, you know, have you seen, you know, if you go to temples, then the brahmacharis and sannyasis will have this, you know, shikha sometimes. So it represents that. And then you start from here and end here. Okay. Then you keep take the beat like this and you keep chanting like this. We should not use this finger. Okay. We should not do it like this. Many people do it like this. That's not recommended. So we should always use the middle finger. And we should take it like this, okay? And sometimes people use this finger, the ring finger. That is also not recommended. So always use the middle finger. And then with this, you place it and then you do like this, okay? So when you do like this and at the end, you will reach here, okay? Finally, you reach back here, okay? And then you flip the beat like this, okay? And then you do another round. So this is called one round of the mantra. And like this, you should be doing some crucial Vishnu mantras, about which I will tell. So the first mantra that you should be doing is Om Namo Narayanaya. This is very important. I will speak about the glories of this mantra some other time. That mantra you can do. And you can also do Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. That mantra is also very important. And apart from that, you can also do the mantra which is done primarily in the Gaudiya Sampradaya, where there is description of Jupiter and Sun and Moon. It's known as the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So you can also do Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. That mantra also you can do. So you should do these mantras at least eight rounds, each of these, okay? So total 24 rounds of these three mantras you should do in the morning. And after that, you could listen to the Ramayana, okay? Or you can listen to the Srimad Bhagavatam, and then you can carry on in the office or your business or work, whatever you have, depending on your schedule or if you have holiday. And then when you come in the night, you can also do another mantra for Vaman Dev, okay? This mantra is specifically for this eclipse, because this eclipse is happening in the sign of Sagittarius. And the Vishnu avatar for for Jupiter is Vaman Dev. Okay. So one important thing you can do is read the story of Bali Maharaj and Vaman Dev. You will find it in the 8th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. Okay. So you can read that from the 8th canto, and you can chant this mantra. Om Namo Bhagavate Shri Vamanaya. This mantra you can chant, alright? And then if you have some time in the morning or in the day, you can also go and give donations, okay? Now many times people ask me that my sun sign is, you know, Scorpio, my lagna is, you know, Sagittarius, what should I donate? So always understand the word donation means anything which is done selflessly. Okay, so if you are thinking about your moon sign and doing some donations, you are simply wasting your time and money, right? That's not donation. You are having a calculation in your mind. Okay, my moon sign is this, I should give this, then I will get this back. All right, so better than giving donations like this, don't give donations. All right, nobody will be happy to accept those donations from you. Okay, so whenever you are giving donations, don't look at your horoscope, don't look at panchang, don't think if I donate in this nakshatra I will get money back. All right, many times people say, oh, we should donate in Punarvasu nakshatra. Why? Because whatever goes back in Punarvasu comes out. I mean, if you are using astrology this way, you are heading on for a big disaster, I'm saying. Okay, so at least for one day, let us not misuse the panchang and, you know, astrological placements, all right? So let us not waste time doing all these things. And whatever we want to donate, we can do it selflessly. Now, donation doesn't only mean that you go and keep donating money, okay? That you can do, or you can... another way to donate is you can donate your time to somebody. Okay, so somebody is in need of you, somebody is wanting your help, then you can go and give your help to that person, okay, without charging any money or without charging any resources. Okay, or you can give some generic help to somebody, okay, not specific, any generic help, right? So that you can do. And don't put a gun on the head of others that, okay, it's eclipse day, you know, you must donate this, you must do this selflessly, do it for me now, right? So you cannot put a gun on somebody. There are people who do this in Kali Yuga. On the day of eclipse, they get messages that, you know, oh, it's eclipse, you know, you must help me today, all right? So don't behave like animals, okay? Let's behave like human beings, civilized human beings, all right? Or let's pretend for one day at least that we are civilized. And once we do this, then we can go to sleep, all right? So the sleep is very important. And on the day of eclipse, it's very important that we sleep straight, okay? So straight means you sleep and then your head is like this and then your body is straight. Okay, straight sleep, not sleeping like this, you know. And try to sleep on a chatai. Chatai means, you know, cot, which is a bit austere, you know, it's very thin. And don't use pillows that day, okay? And of course, if you are in the west, it's very cold, so you might have to use blankets or something like that. Even it's winter, so most part of the world it will be very cold. So if you cannot avoid a blanket, then use a blanket. And if you cannot avoid food, then at least do not take dinner, skip the dinner, okay? And even the next day of the eclipse also, you should do the mantras and the Brahma Samhita and Purusha Sukta prayers in the morning, even in the next day, okay? And then you should again take a bath. And during the day of the eclipse, I forgot to say, ideally you should take bath 3 times a day, okay? And every time you take bath, you should change your clothes, okay? Because if you're going outside, you know, the sunlight can touch you and that is contaminated. The sunlight is considered to be contaminated on the day of eclipse. Okay. So that is why eclipses are very important. And if you use the eclipse properly and if you do the chanting of proper mantras nicely, properly, with a lot of attention and effort and faith, then our consciousness will be transformed. All right. So that is all from my side, and there are many other things which you can do, but I think if you do this much, it will be more than enough. You have done it. If you do all of the remedies which I have said, and if you have time, you can repeat all the mantras, all the 24 rounds you can also do in the evening. Okay. So there's no harm in doing the mantras in the evening also. On the day of eclipse, you can do it. And apart from that, reading of Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam is very essential, all right? And if you have any other mantras which your guru has suggested you have taken diksha from somebody, then go ahead and do those double times, okay? The guru has said do this for 16 times, you do it for 32 times, okay? So during the day of eclipse, we should be very careful. And yes, not to invite Rahu into our lives. Okay, so not to indulge in things that that are prohibited in the scriptures. Okay, so let us be very conscious and make good decisions by which we can use the energy of the eclipse in a right way and not ruin our consciousness by just going in the whims of the mind, as the Bhagavatam says, you know, mano rathe na sati dhavato bahi halava bhaktasya kuto mahatguna. Right? So don't just go on the chariot of the mind from, you know, this boy to this girl, you know, to this TV show, to this reality show, you know. Anyways, we waste time, you know, watching the filthy, disgusting rubbish of this world. So at least on days like eclipse and Janmashtami or Ram Navami, at least on these days, we should try to restrain ourselves, because the Bhagavad Gita says spiritual progress without mind control is simply an illusion. All right, and Krishna says in the Gita, practice and detachment, abhyas and vairagya, these two are the ways by which you can control the mind. Okay, and if you are a meat eater, if you are eating meat by killing animals, then please don't eat meat at least that day, and try to give up meat to whatever extent you can, and abstain from things like alcohol or eating too much sugar or, you know, eating too much spicy food. All right, thank you very much for your patience and wish you all the best for the eclipse. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe to it, and if you want a consultation, you can always go to my website below. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you will find Him. Thank you very much.